My name is Rick Loomis. I'm a photojournalist with the Los Angeles Times. When I arrived in Haiti, it was the day after the earthquake. The first day, I never left the airport. I basically went in with this team of doctors from the University of Miami, and they had a makeshift hospital already set up there right at the airport, and they just had patients just streaming in, basically. And these doctors were pretty amazing. They came and assessed, you know, who had what, who was injured to what degree. So it was pretty chaotic when I got there. There was a kind of crumbled down hotel or half crumbled hotel where I just slept in the lawn with some other journalists. The next morning, sort of my first look around, and everywhere you went was just, you know, destruction, destroyed buildings, dead people. It was pretty unbelievable to the eye. I've been photographing in Iraq and Afghanistan and other places of conflict around the world for a number of years, and I've never seen anything quite like this. You know, the morgue was probably the worst thing I'd ever seen. It was hard to even, you know, shield yourself from it at all. Outside the morgue, there was, you know, thousands upon thousands of bodies that were brought there and just dumped, laying on top of each other. And, you know, that sight, along with the smell and the, you know, trying to walk through, and there's oozing on the ground. I mean, it was just, it was something that won't leave me for quite some time. At times there was a hope that people would be found alive, and many people were found alive. You know, it was a place that you could easily just get lost in with that much misery happening around. And then to see these moments when there was survival and hope and, you know, some tenderness. There's a picture of a man, he's laying down, and there's another man. You can see just his hand coming in and caressing the side of his face. And it was these two gentlemen that were in opposite elevators. They spent 72 hours trapped underneath the rubble. They'd never met, but they'd spent those 3 days keeping each other alive by talking and such. And that was the first time they'd ever met face to face. It was kind of a powerful moment for me. And I returned in November because they were expecting a hurricane to come through. And this hurricane had the potential to come through all these tent cities and really do some damage. And the hurricane, thankfully, largely missed Haiti, or at least the parts that were affected by the earthquake. As I was there, the incidence of cholera kept growing in numbers and growing and growing. And so I went to take a look at cholera and ended up in a city called Gonaive. You know, it's preventable. It's treatable. And due to lack of access to clean water, lack of medical facilities, you know, people are just dying. One of the places I went to was a school. People were just laying there and having IVs put in to try to save them. But even those people, you know, they would languish. They just didn't have enough people to help them. You know, there's a lot of fear about the bodies themselves and how, you know, whether it was transmitted. There's a lack of education there. There was a lot of bodies that were just dumped in the cemetery. And it's just now, since then, it's just swept through the entire country. There's no place that's unaffected by cholera. When I left Haiti after the earthquake, there were still bodies in the street and the stench of the dead just kind of permeating the air in Port-au-Prince. When I came back, there was still just widespread devastation. You know, the streets were largely clean, but there was buildings that just hadn't even been touched yet. The biggest thing was probably these tent cities that started out as just a sheet on the ground had turned into actual cities. You know, there were economies in these tent cities now. You know, there's several people that I photographed that I'd love to know what happened to them, and she's one of them. And, you know, just seeing that girl's eyes just bloodshot like that with an obvious, you know, head trauma. In fact, I still have the idea that if I end up back in Haiti, I kind of know where she might be, and I'll go back.